Well, we're here at the Belgium border. What an exciting event this is. It doesn't say anywhere that it's Belgium, and it's a freezing cold day. We're all in our jerseys and our longs and everything, having a bit of a miserable time. Trucks are still thick, and so we're going to head off. So there's Belgium in front of us. Isn't that riveting? Now, I love this range of product that this guy does. It's, when you have a look at this little house, Mary and I love it. Notice the little shutters in the upstairs area. These are the little ones, and they export anywhere you like. There's a whole range of them. They just put them on a truck and deliver them. This is the definition of a good road. Miles and tons of space. There's lots of grave sites around here, and this is one of them, New Zealand Memorial. Oh, this makes it exciting in these Belgian towns to actually see something move. We've got cycle tracks everywhere, as you can see there and there. No home would be complete without its little windmill. Isn't it beautiful? Okay, the reason for this picture here is because I want to show you the sort of map we're working off. We've got one big book of Europe, and therefore it's 10 kilometers per 1 centimeter. Now, we took a long way around. You'll notice here we've got Berk Plage, the beach, up through Bologna, and Mary knocks it. Okay, Mary's just gone now. She just pushed the map out of the way. Now, look at Bologna, up to Calais. But then that was getting very, very hilly, even though it was in the green area. So across to St. Omer, and down to, God knows where, Hazelbrook. And across the border there at Poperange, and up to, we're now in a place that's not even on the map, and yet it's a town of about 10,000 people. We're going to go up to Brugge tomorrow, and then we're over into the Dutch border. Okay, we're here in Belgium. The town's not even on the map, but we're at a scout camp park, and we've managed to find some Jim Beam. $16 US, not cheap this country, I've noticed. But we're having a spiffing time, and so we'll keep you posted. This is a view looking out from our tent, and this is our little cocktail cabinet here. We've got one Heineken left and a few Coca-Colas at 27 Belgian francs each, which is about 80 cents US. Mary's filling out the diary at the moment, and very conscientiously putting in all the notes necessary. Mary's just getting some takeaways, first sort of junk food in weeks from this place, which is a pub and a bit of an outdoor area. This is just a small town in Belgium, and that's the way to Brugge. Huge motorways here in Belgium. This is one going across to Ghent. Turn around to Mary. Hey, and there we are. The Netherlands border must be the most inconsequential entry to country I've ever seen in all my days.
We've just entered Holland, and this is the province of Zeeland. Much talked about here because people get confused with New Zealand. And here is the man himself, the one and only Robert, doing extremely well navigating every day under pretty difficult circumstances.
Here we are going up one of the canals in Zeeland, and I've just lost my paper bag over into the canal.
Very easy.
Okay, this is a village that's going to be run off this wind power system. It's all just brand new. These long dams covers this beach right around, and these are these massive windmills on the other side. Oh, they looked massive a minute ago. Bit of a funny day today. Very cloudy and very windy. Fortunately, the wind's behind us for a change. It's one of these huge dikes.
Here's a motor camping called Dini Dini. And as you can see from the background, people take this sort of camping very, very seriously. They get set up. It's like they have little homes here. One in the background, and there's also one to the back of us. And they're all in lanes. They've all got gardens, garden sheds, gnomes, and they've all got their garden sheds. We're not allowed to wild camp, as they call it here in Netherlands, and apparently there's a fine of 200 guilders if you do, because the Dutch like to get every cent out of you.
Rotterdam, damn big place. Miserable day. We've just managed to cycle through the whole of the city, one of the biggest seaports in the world. Just north of Rotterdam, we've come across the suburbs now. A lot of people have canals, and here's one canal with these and their babies. Goslets, I think they're called.
First minor example of one of the really nice houses here in the Netherlands. This, these shutters in these red and white colours, and the thatched roof. Actually, the Dutch used to do a lot of thatching. They don't do as much now, but you still see quite a few of these places.
Here we are in Utrecht, and we've decided to take a hotel. And Mary's having a shower. I know she's not, she's having a bath for once in about 3 weeks. Just on the way to Emmen now, Emmen, just by the German border. We're here in Germany, in more power lines and windmills and the odd nuclear power station. I don't know how those cows would feel if it went up. Germany's a great one for these power lines. They're just everywhere. We're having lunch here by this little brook in this cemetery, outside Nordenham in North Germany. This is a place called Verden, the very north, just out of Bremerhaven. And the purpose of the shot is just to show you a bit of this North German architecture. Very steep roofs and huge houses which have barns attached. That's quite a nice one. There's Mary Lou waiting for me to finish filming. These cigarette machines are everywhere in Germany. On the side of buildings, on the sides of, on the front gates of houses. Denmark. On the bridge on a very misty day, going over to the mainland. And yes, cycle tracks. There's Mary Lou over there. And we're heading now off to Copenhagen, but first of all, Copenhagen, here we are. What is it?
Special.
Special.
Very. This is just the Statue of Liberty, the same one you have in the front of the New York.
Ah, yes.
And can you see it?
Yes.
Yes, it's because the three dots in Christiania, the three dots over the eyes are the three yellow dots in the Christiania flag.
Oh, yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so that's the reason why you have these three yellow dots. Yeah, so they moved the entrance a little more far away from here.
It's Christiania.
Christiania is a free town in Copenhagen where people can live and they put themselves a little bit outside the rules of the state.
Entrance to Christiania, and you can see the three yellow dots in the road heart.
Oh, yes.
The red heart.
Got three more in his bag. Wonder if he can handle those.
What?
Do you have to
bring
it
back?
What does this mean?
What does it mean? I don't know.
It means plenty of beer.
That's very important, of course.
16 people.
It's really is.
Yes, improvised.
So, and it has this very special saddle on it.
Yes.
So you can see. You sit quite well on it, I see.
That's right, it's because you've got a lot of bells on there.
The tower there is school of theater.
Yeah.
This is school of music, and over there is school of architecture, and there's also school of film.
Yes, this is Copenhagen. We were staying just across this bridge here and just up before the other bridge and right in the middle there was where Britta had her place. This view shows the Parliament buildings and you'll notice all the town is surrounded by moats. We've arrived at Britta's place, which is North Zealand, in fact, spelt exactly the same way as New Zealand. And Britta's a person who we met in Copenhagen. She's been very good to us, and she said we could stay in her summer house. As you can see, it's not really summer, for a few days. So I'll take you for a little walk around here. Okay, now we'll go for a little walk down through the house here. And it's very nice. I mean, the trees are just everywhere. Lovely little gardens and things like that. This little cottage, which I'd be more than happy with, but however, there's a much bigger place that she's offered us. Isn't this just idyllic? It's just beautiful around here. This lovely big, huge trees. Looks like a ginormous Christmas tree. Quite a massive place, actually. Looks a bit small here, but it's rather large. Coming up to the entranceway here, which I can't get in. I'll have to go around the other side. Okay, we'll go inside and have a look. There's an enormous amount of room in here. Very large lounge. Got a TV that barely works. Oh, Mary's trying to clean out the fireplace for her. What an awful lot of silk there is. Kronborg Castle, Denmark, which we're leaving now.